Hey, what's up guys? I'm Tiger with Tiger Pro Media, back with another Dokkan Battle video. And today, I'm going to tell you guys how to get all 7 of the global 4-year anniversary Dragon Balls from the Wish Upon an Eternal Dragon event. Now, of course, I realize that this video is super, super late. But, as some of you guys may know, I was just on a 3-day family camping trip and literally just returned last night, so I didn't really have a lot of time over the past couple days to film videos, but you know what? I was reading on Twitter and Instagram and even some YouTube comments that some people were actually having some trouble collecting these balls. So for that reason, I wanted to make sure to get this video out there so that all of my subscribers would be set. So with all that said, guys, let's jump right into it. And the first thing I wanted to mention is that depending on when you're watching this video, not all of these levels or stages will be available yet, because the way this event works is that we get one new level every single day from the beginning of part 2 of the 4-year anniversary, right? So on the first day we got level 1, on the second day we got level 2, yesterday we got level 3, and today, the day this video is being filmed, which is July 25th, we should be getting level 4 in a couple hours. So that's where we're at right now. If you guys are watching this video the day that it comes out, then you should be able to clear up to level 4, and then tomorrow's level 5, the day after that's level 6, and then the day after that is level 7, where we can collect the final Dragon Ball, summon Black Smoke Shenron, and go from there. But I just wanted to make that clear, just in case some people were, you know, watching this within the next like 2 or 3 days and are kind of confused about why not all the levels are available. So there you go. Now, of course, this event is where we get the Dragon Balls, but the main topic of this video is what are the conditions you need to meet to get the Dragon Balls from each stage. And for that, we gotta go to the next page here and move down a little bit, and here we have all the hints that we get every single day, as well as the condition or explanation for what that hint actually means, right? So we have them all in order here: stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, so on and so forth. And let's just start from the very top. So for stage 1, to get the 6-star Dragon Ball from that stage, it says gain the support of a Pervy Pig and clear stage 1 of Wish Upon an Eternal Dragon. And for all Dragon Ball fans, you should know that the Pervy Pig is, of course, Oolong. And the condition, or what this means, is that you have to obtain 1 support item Oolong or 1 Oolong support item and clear stage 1 of the event. And originally, when I first saw this, I kind of thought you had to use an Oolong item, so I brought one with me on the stage, used it, got the Dragon Ball. But then I saw that you actually don't have to activate an Oolong. What you have to do is just pick up an Oolong in the stage and then clear the stage, and you're good to go. You'll get that Dragon Ball. So it's super, super simple, super, super easy. And that's for stage 1. For stage 2, it says obtain the mysterious water that powers you up and clear stage 2 of the event. And this one is very similar to the stage 1 hint, actually, and it says obtain 1 training item, sacred water, and clear stage 2 of the special event. So just like stage 1, all you gotta do is pick up a sacred water training item along the way and clear the event or clear the stage, and you should get the 2-star Dragon Ball from this. So for these two, honestly, a lot of people probably just cleared them and got the Dragon Ball without even noticing what was going on, because, you know, you're just gonna naturally be picking up stuff along the way when you're going through a stage, right? So I know for me personally, I kind of just accidentally did it, and I'm sure that applied to a lot of you as well. All right, so that's stage 1 and 2, super, super simple, guys. Now moving on to stage 3, and this one is definitely a little bit trickier, and I feel like this is the one that a lot of people actually had trouble with, because the clue was a little bit ambiguous for people that are not, you know, kind of very hardcore Dragon Ball fans, or it's been a really long time since you watched Dragon Ball. And the clue here was clear stage 3 of Wish Upon an Eternal Dragon with an ally who loves to exercise, learn, play, eat, and rest. And this is actually a reference to Master Roshi in Dragon Ball, where he said this in an episode, right? So like I said, if you guys haven't watched Dragon Ball or it's been a really long time, then this one would be confusing. And what this is actually telling you to do is to form a team with at least one character possessing the Link skill, Turtle School, and clear stage 3 of the special event. So you can obviously, you know, look through your box and filter by specific links as well. So do that and then clear the stage with that unit on your team, and you should get the 4-star Dragon Ball for this stage. And now moving on to stage 4, it says clear stage 4 with the pure one of the warrior race. And what that means is just to clear stage 4 with at least one character with the pure Saiyans category, or one character in the pure Saiyans category. So, you know, Goku's, Vegeta's, Kale, Caulifla, Kaba, so on and so forth. Do that and you'll get the 5-star Dragon Ball. Moving on to stage 5. It says clear stage 5 with the legendary warrior who strikes fear into even Frieza. And all you gotta do is just bring at least one unit with the Super Saiyan Link. And for stage 6, it says clear stage 6 with a bunch of super warriors of one color. And that means to clear stage 6 with a team made up of characters from super class and from the same type. So essentially, bring a mono super type team. So you can do a full team of super AGL units, a full team of super tech units, a full team of super physical units. Doesn't really matter. It's totally up to you. As long as they're all super types and all of the same type, you should be good to go and you'll get the 7-star Dragon Ball. And for the last ball, it says clear stage 7 with an ally who played a role in the Majin Buu saga. Pretty self-explanatory there as well. Clear stage 7 with at least one character with the Majin Buu saga category, or in the Majin Buu saga category. And that's pretty much all there is to it, guys. If you do everything that I said in this video and clear each of these stages in these specific ways, then you should be able to collect all 7 of the Dragon Balls. And as a nice bonus, you also get 4 Dragon Stones per ball that you collect. And from there, can finally summon the Black Smoke Shenron, who literally just escaped. he's gonna come back. But yeah, so what you do is collect the balls, summon Black Smoke Shenron, who is right there, and once you do that, you'll unlock a new event called The Universe is in Peril, Birth of the Shadow Dragons. And for this event, you fight the Shadow Dragons in order, and each of these stages actually has some kind of condition or some kind of restriction. So for stage 1, you must have Giru on your team. Stage 2, the boss nullifies all ki blast attacks. Stage 3, the boss can only be defeated with super attacks. Stage 4, any Pan character cannot be on the team, so you can't use Pans. Stage 5, boss has a chance of evading attack. Stage 6, boss has coercion, which stops the player from rearranging certain characters. And stage 7, Super Saiyan 4 Goku will deal increased damage. So you go through the levels, beat all the Shadow Dragons, and once you're done that, you'll be able to unlock a new Extreme Z battle event. And you can see that over here for Omega Shenron. Now, unfortunately, it's not to Extreme Z awaken any of the Omega Shenrons in the game. But essentially what happens is you fight Omega Shenron and you can collect copies of the Int Spirit Bomb GT Goku, as well as all the medals you need to Extreme Z awaken him too. So you get the copies from 1 to 10 and then get a bunch of medals between 9 or 11 to 40. So you get all the medals you need to Extreme Z awaken him between those levels, and then between levels 41 to 50 you get more copies. So basically enough copies to rainbow him, fully dupe him out, and also get him to SA15. And if you go beyond that, you guys can get so many awesome rewards, just good stuff, man, like orbs, Kais. I mean, they're sleepy Kais, so that kind of sucks, but you got a lot of them, which is great. And also some training items if you want to go beyond level 100. And in total, you can get 20 copies of the Int Goku. You can get all the medals to awaken him, or Extreme Z awaken him. You can get 50 Sleepy Kais, 50, so maybe 10 of those will work, something like that. So think of it like 10 Kais, like 10 normal Kais. And also enough orbs to rainbow one unit of each type, which is just absolutely Amazing, that is a lot of orbs. And if for some reason you go to level 999, I don't know if it's possible to be honest, but let's say you get there, you can get a total of 899 of each of these training items. And that is pretty much it, guys. That's gonna be it for the video. That's the entire process of how to, you know, get the Dragon Balls from this event, summon Black Smoke Shenron, unlock the Shadow Dragons event, and then eventually unlock the Extreme Z Battle Omega Shenron event, get the Int Spirit Bomb Goku, and that's pretty much it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video today, hopefully you guys found it helpful. And if you guys do have some questions about anything I said in this video, maybe something that was confusing or I wasn't clear on, leave a comment down below. Let me know what is confusing to you, and I will try my best to help you out. But that's pretty much going to do it for the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. As always, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. But other than that, I don't have much else to say. It's great to be back. I'm very excited to make you guys more Dokkan content for the 4-year anniversary. So get ready for that. Stay tuned. And I'm out of here. Hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.